What is up, amigos? Today we're talking about shape factors, and this is relating to boundary layers. So in the last two videos, we went through the displacement thickness, which if you don't know what that is, check out this video. And we went through the momentum thickness of a boundary layer. And if you don't know what that is, check out this video here. So we're gonna be using these two in this video here. So the shape factor, what is that? Well, as I mentioned, it pertains to the boundary layer, and we denote it by a number, by a letter H. And this equals the displacement thickness, delta 1, divided by the momentum thickness, delta 2. And this gives us a number. So we calculated these two values in the last two videos, the equations we gave and how to do that. And then you can get the shape factor here. So what is this and why do we use it? Well, if we have a boundary layer in a pipe, which is called a bounded boundary layer, and the flow comes in and it creates this boundary layer here, and we can calculate the displacement thickness and the momentum thickness, and we calculate the shape factor for this position. Let's say it's H1. Then later on, we calculate it again, and we see that the shape factor is H2. Depending on what these numbers are, we can determine what is happening to the boundary layer at any point in time. And if the shape factor H is approximately 2.59, so let's say between 2.2 and 2.6, this tells us that the boundary layer is most likely laminar, which is a really cool feature. We can determine that just by this number. If H, on the other hand, H is approximately, let's say 1.3, let's say between 1.3 to 1.4, then we can say that the boundary layer is turbulent. And in both of these cases, the boundary layer has really no chance of separating as it is. But let's say we now have a curved surface and the flow is going over it, and the boundary layer may or may not separate, and we want to know that. Well, again, we can calculate what the momentum thickness is and the displacement thickness, calculate what the shape factor is, and if the shape factor is approximately 2.7, then that tells us that the boundary layer is most likely turbulent, and the flow is probably going to separate around this point. So the shape factor is incredibly powerful at telling us what is happening in the boundary layer, whether it's laminar or turbulent, and in certain cases, if the flow will separate. So that is why we want to know what the displacement thickness is and the momentum thickness is in terms of a practical point of view, and how to use that to determine what the boundary layer is doing. So that is the end of this video. If you'd like to, make sure to like it and click the subscribe button, and I'll see you next video. Peace out, amigos.